Hello students, today I am going to discuss another model of memory, that is levels of processing. It is also called depth of processing. It was given by Fergus Craik and Robert Lockhart in the year 1972. Let's begin. Its characteristics. It is a non-structured approach. According to them, memory is really what happens as a result of processing information. For them, it is very important that we study levels of processing in order to understand memory. They said that the level of processing that an individual uses to process the incoming data, to process the information, it determines how deeply the information is encoded into memory. They are basically interested in studying the processing, level of processing, that is shallow processing or deep processing. If you are using shallow processing, your memory traces will be fragile, but if you are using deep processing, your memory traces will be stronger, will be durable. So for them memory is just a byproduct of the depth of processing. That's it. They don't want to discuss about the difference between short-term and long-term memory. They were not interested in studying the structure of the memory. Okay. They were interested in studying the levels of processing. So, they provide us with the distinction between shallow and deep processing. Shallow processing, that is when we study the superficial, when we study the perceptual characteristics. That is your shallow processing. Meaning is not involved. Information, it involves information being processed in the way that it actually looks. Means physical characteristics. How the human senses actually recorded perceptual characteristics. We are focusing on the physical characteristics. We are focusing on the structure of the information. Nothing else. But in deep processing, it involves processing meaning. When you understand the concept. When you take into account the examples. When you use links. When you use images. When you use past experience, that is your deep processing, and it leads to longer term comprehension. Memory traces will be stronger, long lasting. So this is the difference between shallow and deep processing. So there are three ways in which verbal information can be processed: structural, phonemic and semantic. First two, structural and phonemic, they come under shallow processing. But the third one, that is semantic, it comes under deep processing. So structure and phonemic, what does it mean? Structure, when we focus upon the visual characteristics, physical characteristics, how things look like. Phonemic, when we take into account sounds. And when we talk about semantic, we are taking into consideration the meaning of the information. Okay. So this is an example. For example, ball. If you are focusing on shallow, if you are focusing on structure and phonemic, then you are talking, then we are talking about the shallow processing. If we say perceptual, then we are taking into consideration how many vowels the word contains. How many vowels are there in this word, that is ball. If you are talking about phonemic, we'll say, what does the word sound like? Is it rhyme with something? This is shallow. And when we are talking about semantic, we will ask, is it an object used to play? Can we play with this? It means we are going into deeper level, elaborative level. Okay. So this is a continuum from shallow to deep. First two shallow, third one semantic is deeper. So there are two types of rehearsal that they also talked about. Well, first is maintenance rehearsal and the second one is elaborative rehearsal. They basically focused upon elaborative rehearsal. Maintenance rehearsal first, what does it mean? It means temporarily maintaining the new information in your short-term memory, and usually works by repetition. You are just repeating your information again and again. Meaning is not involved. For example, repeating your phone number, email address, a new acquaintance name to yourself several times. You are repeating that number again and again until you write it down. So there is no meaning involved. It is just your rote memory. Then is your elaborative rehearsal. Elaborative rehearsal, it involves giving the material organization and meaning as it is being rehearsed. Deeper, you are going into deeper level. It involves thinking about the meaning of the term and connecting it to other information already stored in memory. For example, you have to remember a long string of numbers. So you can use elaborative rehearsal. You might associate them with dates that are personally significant, such as your birthday date, your parents' wedding anniversary date, and likewise. Perhaps you might see a pattern in the numbers that helps you to remember. You can see a pattern like it is going in ascending order, it is going in descending order. So you can remember it quite easily. So this process is effective because now you can relate it to something that is meaningful to you, and it is easier to remember because it is being connected to prior information. So we can use mnemonics, we can use strategies, effective strategies. Okay, we can also use acronyms. It is one type of mnemonic. It could be taking the first letter of a list of items we need to remember and making it a sentence. For example, we can list the planets of the solar system if you want to use elaborative rehearsal. So we can take the first letter from each planet and can create the sentence like, my very educated mother just served us noodles. Isn't it? Now this is easier to remember. Now you can learn the names of the planet in an easier way. Isn't it? Right? Now Pluto is no more the planet. So that's why I have not taken that. So it involves thinking about the meaning of the term to be remembered and connecting it to other information already stored in memory. This is what we mean by elaborative rehearsal. So in order for memories to be transferred to long-term memory, it must have meaning and to be understood. This is what we mean by levels of processing approach. The keywords are shallow and deep processing and rehearsal, two types of rehearsal. Most importantly, elaborative rehearsal. This you have to keep in mind while studying this approach. Okay? Hope you understood. Take care, students. Bye.